Hey guys, Harrison here, and the design of the Google Pixel 2 caused a little bit of a stir up when it was first released. Some people loved it, but some people absolutely hated it. For most people though, it literally doesn't matter what the phone looks like, because as soon as you pull it out of the box, you're going to be slapping a phone case onto the back of it anyway. And for all you people, I've got you covered with three different cases for the Google Pixel 2 and 2 XL, ranging from something dirt cheap to something a little more expensive. Just note that I bought all of these cases myself, and this video is definitely not sponsored. Alright, so I paid all of $1 for this first case, and it's about what you'd expect. It's made of a clear, squishy plastic called TPU, and it'll do a decent job of keeping the back and the sides of the phone safe from little bumps and scratches. You'll want to be extra careful up the front of the phone though if you've got this case on it. There's just the tiniest plastic lip to protect the front of the phone, and the screen protector I've got on my phone actually rests slightly higher than that plastic lip anyway, meaning that you're not going to get much protection up front at all. The cutouts do all line up though, which is much more than I expected for a case that costs literally $1, and you know, overall, for the price you pay, it'll do a decent job. So moving up to $5 gets you a case that does look pretty similar to the one we were just looking at, but it does have a few key differences to it that might help justify its price tag being 5 times more than our first case. The first difference is the colour. This case is quite clearly black, and it has also a matte coating on the back of the case to help protect it from fingerprints that you might get on it, something that the clear case, the $1 case, does seem to be pretty good at attracting. And speaking of protection, the front lip of this case is actually a little bit larger than the cheaper one, meaning that if you've got a screen protector on the front of your phone, you'll still get a little bit of extra protection, and if you don't like to use screen protectors, you'll still benefit from having those extra few millimeters to keep your phone screen safe. Apart from that though, this case is pretty similar to the first one that we looked at. So there's one more case here to show you guys, but before we move on to that, I do just want to quickly mention the Spigen cases for the Google Pixel 2 and Pixel 2 XL. So I don't personally have one of these phone cases, but they do seem to be quite popular and have quite a few positive reviews, so I thought I'd just quickly mention them. Spigen does have a history of making quite a lot of phone cases, so you'd hope they'd be pretty good at it by now. And these come in at a decent price point at around $10 to $15, and they also have quite a few different designs to choose from. And now finally, we've got this $30 case for the Google Pixels from a French company called Incipio. So this is the case that I normally have on my phone, just because it's more rugged than the other two cases that I've got. You can see it's nice and thick, and it's got a nice fat lip around the front of the phone, and you can actually see all the little bumps and scratches where I've been dropping it. So this case is a two-part design with a softer inner shell and a harder outer shell, and this definitely makes for one tough case, but it does also mean that you're going to have quite a bit of extra bulk when you've got your phone in this case, and it can also be a bit of a pain to get this case actually on to your phone. So if you look over on the back, there are a few places where the coating is sort of starting to rub off a bit, but apart from that, I've been using it for 3 or 4 months now, and I have to say it is a pretty good case. So which case is right for you? Now there's no perfect answer to this question, but I'll do my best to guide you to a solution. Case number two, the case that costs $5, the black one, is the case that I would probably recommend to just about anyone that asks just for a cheap, quick case for their Pixel 2. I'd be recommending this case over the first one that we looked at, that cheap $1 one, just because I feel like this case is probably going to last a little bit longer, and it does also have that extra protection up the front of the case. So for some people, that might be all you need, but even if you do end up getting another case, I reckon it's always a good idea just to have a spare one, a second case, just sort of lying around, just in case something happens. If you're after something a little higher quality though, I definitely recommend checking out the Incipio cases for the Pixel 2 and Pixel 2 XL. I've had it on my Pixel 2 now for almost 4 months, and as you could probably tell, it's doing a mighty fine job. And as for those Spigen ones I mentioned, again, I've never actually held one, I've never seen one, but they have been reviewed very highly, and they're definitely something that you'd want to consider. That just about wraps up this video though. Thanks for watching, I hope you enjoyed, and links to all the cases that I've mentioned will be down in the video description, so check those out if you're interested. Also, while you're down there, don't forget to leave a like and subscribe on this video. And let me know in the comments section what videos you guys want to see coming up in the future. I'd love to hear your ideas and suggestions on some videos I can make, so leave those down below in the comments section. Apart from that though, thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in the next video.